the school, by the religion, and by education, and by things, anything in this world, but nobody can change a person. Only the Lord Jesus Christ can change us. Okay, thank you for that wonderful song. So for this afternoon, I know you are ready to sleep. No, I hope. I was okay. Let's open our Bible in the book of Acts. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts. Acts chapter 16. Let's all stand up. Acts chapter 16, verses. Let's read. Let's start from verse 25 until verse 40. Acts 16, 25 to 40. Okay, let's read this responsibly. Acts 16, 25 to 40. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. Then he called for a light and sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas. And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house." And he took them the same hour of the night, and washed their stripes, and was baptized, he and all his straightway. And when it was day, the magistrates sent the sergeants, saying, "Let those men go." But Paul said unto them, "They have beaten us openly, uncondemned, being Romans, and have cast us into prison. And now do they thrust us out privily? Nay, verily, but let them come themselves and fetch us out." And they came and besought them and brought them out and desired them to depart out of the city altogether. And they went out of the prison and entered the house of Lydia. And when they had seen the brethren, they comforted. Okay, let's pray. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you for this time that we can study your word. I pray, Lord, that you will guide us, give us wisdom. Let the Holy Spirit be our teacher this afternoon. I pray, Lord, that you will illumine our hearts. Thank you so much for this word that can encourage us in whatever situation we have, whatever circumstances we have. We know, Lord, that you are always there and will never leave us, and you are always in control. Thank you so much, Lord, for your faithfulness, for your protection, and for your blessing to each every one of us. We praise you and glorify your name. All these things I ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, so prior to this incident, we know when Paul had a dream, he had a vision about a man standing and inviting him to come in Macedonia. And for sure it was a vision came from God. And Paul knew that he was called to go there. And what he did, he followed that vision and he went to Macedonia, particularly in Philippi, one of the city in Macedonia. And when they arrived there, they ministered to the many people there, and also one of their convert was Lydia, and other Lydia. And then they encountered a person who were possessed by an evil spirit. Was lady or girl was used by her master to gain money para yung pagkakitaan. And then these ladies keep on following them and telling them that these are the one who will tell about God. But Paul rebuked that lady, and then the devil, the evil spirit, came out from that girl, and the master become mad, and we know the story. And the master of that lady who used her to gain money tell to the magistrate that Paul and Silas are these people are making trouble in their city. That's why what happened to them, they were cast into the prison here in verse 23. And when they had in verse 22, and the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrate rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. So they were beaten, and when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely, who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. Now, if you're going to look at their situation, we know that they follow the will of God in their life. And it also happened in our life that we know the will of God because it came from God through His Word. We cannot see vision anymore today because the Bible is already complete. But during their time, Paul saw a vision, and then they follow that vision. They follow the will of God. But what happened to them is this: they received a stripe, they were beaten, and when they were beaten, and we know that these Roman soldiers are really, when they give punishments, really painful. So imagine, I'm trying to imagine what is their situation there, what happened to their back. They said they laid many stripes in their back, and it seems that it's not the will of God for them. But you know, and what else, what happened to them? They put in inner prison. This is not just an ordinary prison. And they mention is inner, it means in a place that is so, maybe yung pinaka dulong-dulong presuhan. It is dark, cold, maybe lots of rats. So that's what their situation. And then, with this situation, we can say that they have the right to complain. They have the right to say, Lord, what is happening to us? We follow your will. We obey what you want us to do. But what's wrong? But you know what happened to them? They didn't do that. Now, what we're going to study here is their secret. Now, the title of my message today, How Paul and Silas Live Victorious. You know, it's really easy to be victorious when things are things is happening according to our way, when things are okay, when things are we feel good, we have income, we have jobs, it's easy to praise the Lord with that. But when it comes to difficult times, that's the time that we can say, we can test if we can really give thanks or we can live victorious as a Christian. Now here in verse number 6, now how Paul and Silas live victorious, number 1, in verse 25, it says here, "And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them." Imagine what they did in spite of their situation. They nakuha pa nilang manalangin. Now, when I'm thinking about this, we are experiencing pandemic, we're experiencing loss of our job, our income really goes down, at saka there are many bills that we cannot, we need to pay, we need to adjust. And I try to think, during that time did I say, "Lord, thank you for this time that you have given to us." And did I pray? Did I sing praises? When I look at myself, because you know, as a human person, our default is to complain, is to ask God why it's happening to us, why it's happening to me. I'm inside your will, oh God, but why? Sometimes we ask that. But here, Paul and Silas, they live victorious because in their life, first they give thanks and sing praises to God. They knew God was in charge. They knew that God is in control of their situation. You know, if we know and we really understand that God is always in control, we will become we will feel safe. I don't know if you try to ride in a car or a bus that you see the driver is just a nuisance or a new driver. What will maybe you will not feel, you will feel uneasy and you will not secure because you know that the driver is not it's only new. But if you know that the driver is really a professional driver, you can sleep riding the vehicle. Now, what happened to Paul and Silas is like that. They knew that God is in charge. That's why they said, "Oh, these things, I know God is controlling all of this." They were rejoicing in the Lord, not their circumstances. They don't rejoice. They rejoice in the Lord. You know, anyone can be happy in pleasant circumstances. But real joy comes only from within. And it's a gift available to Christian at all times. You know, only true Christian can experience this real joy. Sometimes, yung merong samba in our family, somebody passed away, or we have a big problem, but still we can say, "Thank you, Lord, for this blessing." I remember Job. You know, Job, everything was removed from him, but what he said, "The Lord give it, the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." Now, if you're going to think that, can I really say that in situation? When I'm, you know, when these things happen, when we have probably experienced problem, talagang it's really difficult. We understand our pastor, what he experiencing right now. That is really hard because we are also affected. Each, every one of us were affected. And last Friday, I keep on praying, "Lord, na maging yung maging maayos ang lahat, na hindi yung kung ano, hindi kasinungalingan ang manaig." But praise the Lord, God answered our prayer. And also, I remember yung prayer ni Moses, sabi niya, na Panginoon, dinala niyo ang Israel dito sa wilderness. Anong papatayin niyo lang buko mami dito? Anong sasabihin ng ibang tao? Ano sasabihin lang? Parang ganun din ang isip ko. Dinala niyo po kami dito, Panginoon. Tapos magkakaganito lang na para bang masisira yung pangalan ng iglesia ng Panginoon dahil sa mga masasamang, may mga tao, may masasamang balak. But praise the Lord, it doesn't happen. So we praise God for His divine intervention. And we can be we can give thanks and give praise to God in difficult time and in whatever circumstances we have. Noah, instead of cursing man, they blessed God. Instead of saying, yung kung ano-ano sabihin nila, but they blessed God. They were a testimony to the other prisoners because the prisoners was listening to them. Why these people, instead, in spite of their situation, they still sing and praise? I know for sure, but they also preach the word of God when they are here in this situation. You know, we are a better testimony when things are tough. When things are tough, we are a better testimony. You know, it's really easy to give testimony when things are go along our way. When things are okay, it's really easy to stand up. I praise God for blessing me. I praise God for giving me this, increasing my salary from 500 to 3,000. 3,000 a year. 3,000. It's easy to say that. But can we say if we lost our job, we don't have income anymore, and we are struggling financially, can we say, praise the Lord, I'm struggling right now? It's really hard. But if you are, this is the secret of Paul and Silas, why they live victorious. They give thanks. In Ephesians 5:20, says there, giving thanks always, he said, for all things unto God. All things, either difficult things, easy things, all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And in Philippians 4:4, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. You know, this verses was written, it was Paul who wrote this. And that's why he applied whatever situation he had, he experienced, they still give thanks. Ano lang po, napakasarap pakinggan ng mga tao mapagpasalamat. Diba? If you are really grateful and thankful on what you have, it is a great encouragement. We need to be thankful because the Bible says we need to give thanks always and rejoice always. Now others will see that our faith, Christ, and testimony are real if we will do this. If people see that in spite of our situation, we have having hard time, but we still give praises to God. You know, minsan sa paghuhugas lang, di ba? Sa bahay kami, talagang pag ako na-assign sa hugas, talaga, tinatago ko yung mga kaldero sa ilalim para hindi makita. Tapos paghugas na ng ate ko, nilalabas, may hugasan pa rito. Parang ang hirap maghugas nung kumakanta ka, no? Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. May kinakanta natin siguro, why have you chosen me? Bakit ako naghuhugas dito? You know, but we need to give thanks and sing praises. I don't know if you are, you know, it's really pleasant to see a person singing when doing things, when things are tough and things are difficult. Yung iba yung mararamdaman. Katulad dito sa mga those fellow prisoners and those who can even the guard, those who are listening to Apostle Paul and Silas, they show a good testimony. They, for sure, they ask, what's wrong with you? You are in difficult situation. Why are you still doing that? Why you give thanks and praises to God? For sure, they share and they have a good testimony with others and to their fellow prisoner and also to those people who yung nagbabantay sa kanila. So that is there. That's how they live victorious. They give thanks and sing praises to God. And number two, mabilis lang po ito. Number two, in verse 26, and suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. They didn't know their future. Number two, they didn't know their future, but they know who holds it. So they never took their eyes off of God. God never took his eyes off of them. God is waiting for us to focus on him. We need to know that whatever situation we have, God is in control. We know that God is holding our future. We don't know what will happen to us tomorrow. That's why the things that we can do is just pray and hope to God. And whatever will happen to us, that is the will of God for us. So if we will, like what I'm praying to God, Lord, I don't know if we can still survive this situation, but I know you're the one who brought us here. You're the one who bring us here. Kayo nagbigay ng tatlong anak sa amin. Ang plano ko isa lang eh. Dumami. I know God gave that and I was really thankful. I know God will supply. We experience yung we are in a masagana, di ba? Talagang sarap mag-testimony, di ba? Praise the Lord, we have something yung tinatanggap namin, this and this, ewan kung naalala nyo pa yun. Di ba? Ngayon, this and this. But praise the Lord, we don't know what will happen to us for tomorrow, but we know God is in control. That's what they did here. In verse 27, says here, and the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. You know, here supposing can be costly thing. Don't suppose when it comes to your salvation. Maybe you are thinking that you are saved. Like there are people who think they are saved, but we cannot see the fruit of salvation. You know salvation of fruit. And where you will spend your eternity. Like this, yung Philippian guard here. Na akala niya, he supposed that everybody was fled and escaped. That's why he tried to kill himself. But Paul, here in verse 28, but Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. We can see here that God is in control. You know, if you are a prisoner, if the prison will open, what will you do? You will just run and you say, freedom, I'm free. But you can see here the hand of God. There are all prisoners, they lose their chains, the door was open, but they stayed. They didn't go, they didn't escape. That's why Paul said, that's why this, yung guardia, yung Philippian jailer, sabi niya, I will kill myself, because he knows the punishment. If a prisoner will escape, he will die also. That's why he tried to kill himself, but Paul said, no, don't do that, because it's not, we are still here. God, in verse 28 and verse 29, but Paul cried out with a loud voice, saying, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. Then he called for a light and sprang in, and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas. We can see here that God was at work, because nobody escaped. You know, God is always in charge. It would have been easy for Paul and Silas to escape, thinking that God has instigated another miraculous jailbreak. But to them, the lives of others were more important than their own personal freedom and comfort. They know that God, this is the hand of God that's happening. You know, yung nag-earthquake lang, pwede na silang magtakbuhan nun, pero hindi yun. Paul and Silas knew that God has something for them to do in that situation. In not escaping, they showed tremendous discernment. The circumstances said, escape, we need to escape. But love said, stay for the sake of this one soul. They were not guided merely by circumstances, but by what love compelled. So this is what happens sometimes to us. We are guided by circumstances. I remember there are some who was here in the church before. Because of the pandemic, they said, we need to go home. We have nothing to benefit here. Wala nang pakinabang dito, mag-uwian na tayo. Diba? If we will do that, kung lahat tayo ganun nasa isip, anong mangyayari? Diba? Wala. At talagang lalabas, you know, it will come out what inside of you in difficult situation, in difficult circumstances. But because of love, because Paul and Silas loved the soul, and they knew that God is in control, they stayed instead of they need to escape, because that is our first thing we need to do to secure ourselves. Remember, if difficult times, we keep on we need to ipon-ipon, and we need to save for ourselves. And then there are some people who wala naman na sila rito, salamat. Maraming tao talaga nag-ipon, tapos ang gagamitin, mangungutang sa iyo para gamitin yung sa iyo, yung sa kanila iponin lang. Barang hindi po magandang ugali yung ganun. It's not really a Christian attitude to always think of yourself and try to exhaust the savings of your brethren. No, you need to be fair and you need to share. So yung mga gusto mag-share, lapit lang sa akin. So that's what happened. They didn't know the future, their future, but they know who holds it. They don't know what will happen to them, if they will die on that time, but they know God is in control. God is holding their future. So that's number two. Now let's go to number three. Verse 30. And brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" You know, in number three, they show a good testimony. Paul and Silas had a good testimony. You know, the jailer saw their relationship with Jesus Christ, their consistency and their thankfulness no matter the circumstances. You know, the jailer was so impressed by Paul and Silas, by the love they showed to him, and from their ability to take joy even in misery, that he instantly wants the kind of life that Paul and Silas have. Because this jailer, he saw the testimony of Paul and Silas. What happened to these people? They were beaten. They laid stripe in their back, and they put in prison, in a dark prison. For sure, it's hot, smelly, or whatever. There are lots of insects, but they still praise the Lord. They give thanks and give glory to God. That's why the jailer wants them. That kind of ugali, yung the one that they showed to that situation. That's why the prisoner said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved? I want to have like that, what you have." And what do people see in you and me that would want them to know our Christ? Ano ba nakikita sa atin? Baka if people will see us, maybe they will said, "Oh, I don't want to go to the church. Look at him, look at her. So, I don't want to be like that." It's a bad testimony, but Paul and Silas show a good testimony. That's why their testimony invited people to come to the Lord Jesus Christ. Because I remember the saying that they looking at our walk. Sometimes they are not listening to our talk. Oh, they're judging from your action every day. The song, "Don't believe You'll deceive by taking what you've never known. They accept what they see and know you to be. They judge you from your life alone. Ano bang kantang yun? Nakalimutan ko na yung kanta. Because they keep on looking on our life. And what we can, or what we are showing to them will have an impact in their decision. That's why this jailer saw Paul and Silas. That's why he said, so, sir, I want to be saved like you. And then, in verse 31 says here, and they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. What they did, they pointed people to Jesus. They said, it's the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul's answer to the keeper of the prison is a classic statement of the essence of the gospel. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. This is salvation by grace alone, received by faith alone. So it was, they didn't say, no, because we are a good person, because we are like this, we are like that. But they said, it's because the Lord Jesus Christ. We need to point people to Jesus. We don't need to point to others, because only the Lord Jesus Christ can save them. Only the Lord Jesus Christ can change their life. That's why it's really hard to listen to those preaching who are lifting themselves, lifting others, other pastor. Somebody will invite, for example, a pastor will invite another pastor in order to lift him up. And then vice versa, he will go to his church and he will lift him up. It's not a Christian way of life. It must be, we need to point people to Jesus Christ because they need God in their life. Now in verse 33 to 34, and he took them the same hour of the night and washed their stripes and was baptized, he and all his straightway. And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them and rejoiced, believing in God with all his house. The jailer was a changed man. After that incident, Paul said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And we are thinking, oh, that's an easy believism. No, because the jailer, he's repenting of his sin. Because he humbled himself, said he was repenting by fell down and trembling. He believed that Jesus Christ is God. That's why he brought Paul and Silas to their house. He cleaned their wounds and give them food. And then verse 35 and 36. So that's number 4. They pointed people to Jesus. And number 5. Verse 35 and 36. And when it was day, the magistrate sent the sergeant, saying, let those men go. And the keeper of the prison told his saying to Paul, and the magistrates have sent to let you go now. Therefore, depart and go in peace. Number 5, they think of other people's safety. So they think of this jailer. That's why they don't escape. Because for sure, if they will escape, what will happen to this jailer? He will be punished to death. That's why they stayed. Oh, we'll stay here in prison. We will not go. And we can see that the hand of God is in control. Paul and Silas did leave the prison, but in the protective custody of the jailer, to minister to the jailer's household. But Paul and Silas returned to the prison willingly to spare the jailer certain death. They don't think of themselves, they think of other people. So that's what the Jesus Christ is telling us. We need to love others as ourselves. We need to think of others. Sometimes we are always thinking of our safety, of our security. We need to secure ourselves. We don't need to think of others. No, it's not a biblical way of living as a Christian. We need to think of others safely. That's why there are people who keep on saying stories and telling lies to protect themselves. and to destroy other people. They don't think of others. For sure, I believe that they, I don't know if they were really saved. Because that's not yung gawain ng isang ligtas na tao. You are always thinking of yourself. You know, if you are keep on thinking of yourselves for your safety and for your benefit, you need to ask, am I really saved? Am I really doing the will of God? Because the Lord Jesus Christ, He was thinking of us. Diba? Iniwan niya, He left His glory in heaven in order for us to be saved. He don't even think of Himself, He think of us. So, that's what Paul and Silas did. They think of other people safely. If Paul and Silas were released the day after their beating, arrest, and imprisonment, why did God send the earthquake? We see that the earthquake had absolutely nothing to do with freeing Paul and Silas from prison, but it had everything to do with the salvation of a certain prison guard and his household. That's the purpose why God sent an earthquake, not to free all of them, because if that, they will just run away. But there's a purpose in order to yung maligtas yung Philippian jailer and his household. And then in verse 37 and 39, but Paul said unto them, they have beaten us openly and condemned, being Romans, and have cast us into prison, and now do they trust us out privily? Privily ba yan? O privily? Privily. May verily, but let them come themselves and fetch us out. And the surgeons told these words unto the magistrates, and they feared when they heard that they were Romans. So in number 6, in verse 39, and they came and besought them and brought them out and desired them to depart out of the city. Number 6, they were harmless like a dove and wise as a serpent. But Bible says be harmless like a dove and wise as a serpent. Paul said, they have beaten us openly and condemned Romans. We know that Paul and Silas, they were a Roman citizen. And when we study that in Bible school, you know, being a Roman citizen, it's really a privilege. During those times, if you are a Roman citizen, all the benefits, all the ayun mga benefits ng Roman citizen will be yours. And if you are mistreat yung ano ba yun, ginawa ka ng masama, ang kalaban nila ay yung gobyerno ng yung Roman government. But because Paul and Silas were Roman citizen, they had recognized civil rights. They have civil rights. They were grievously violated by the Philippian magistrates. Upon learning this, the magistrates are filled with fear because it was a grave offense to treat Roman citizens as Paul and Silas had been treated. You know why didn't Paul and Silas reveal their Roman citizenship earlier when they were captured by this magistrate and then when they were judged? They didn't reveal that, oh, we are Roman. We are Romans. It is possible that they didn't have the opportunity, but it is more likely that the Holy Spirit was directing them to not reveal it until a certain time. The Holy Spirit is telling them, no need to do that. Just go and follow, and because they first, they know that God is at work. God is doing, that God has a plan. You know, our rights are not as important as our obedience to the will of God. God may ask us to lay down our rights for the good of another. In this case, for the good of the Philippian jailer. You know, we have, as a human, we have rights, right? Human rights. But we don't need to insist our rights when it comes to obedience to the will of God. So, but with this case, Paul and Silas didn't mention that they are a Roman citizen because they know that God has a purpose, and they need to obey that. How could Paul and Silas have proved their Roman citizenship? They may each have carried a copy of the of his profession or registration of birth, in which his Roman status would have been recorded. These were a convenient insight to claim Roman citizenship falsely was punishable by them, because Roman citizenship can be acquired, or you can, if you are, we study, I remember, you can, if you were born in a Roman, what do you call that? Roman, nasasakop ng Roman Empire, you will be citizen, and also you can pay, something like that, and you will become a Roman citizen. And they didn't even, they didn't show that. They didn't say that we have the privilege, but they need to follow God. Now, we can see here that they were really harmless like Adam, but they were wise as serpent. Because they said, you were beaten us publicly. Inihiya nyo kami. Di ba? Tapos, ngayon, babalikan kayo. Gusto nyo, tahimik na lang. Di ba? Kaya iniisip ko, may nangyayari sa atin ngayon. Publicly, they were try to destroy the church. They will try to destroy, sometimes all of us trying to destroy by these people. And then I know time will come, God will do something. And if they do that in public, I don't know what God will do. But we're praying that everything will be in God's will and in His control. So just keep on praying. And then after that, last number 7, in verse 40, and they went out of the prison. Ayun, kasi inano sila, sige, siguro nang hingi ng sorry dito. Sige, lalabas na namin kayo. Sinundo sila. Pinakita na they want to show that they don't have any walang kasalanan. Wala kaming masamang ginawa. We don't do things that's against to your government, against the Roman government. That's why you need to show to the public that we have a clean conscience. So the magistrate bring them out. And then after that, they encouraged the brethren. They agreed to go, but only after they had seen the brethren encourage them. Paul and Silas would not be hurried out of the town until they had brought their work there to a conclusion. In Philippi, Paul and Silas left behind two notable converts. There is a Lydia and the prison guard. And we know this, what do you call that? Gentiles were used by God in order to spread the gospel to those people. Each of these to have their lives touched by Jesus in every different ways. So before they leave the place, they want to visit the brethren to encourage them. You know, whatever situation we have, we can still encourage our brethren. We need to. You don't need to say, it happens to you because you have hidden sin. Malamang may mga kasalanan kang ginagawa kaya nangyayari yan sa'yo. Hindi po dapat ganun. Because we always have the benefit of the doubt. We don't know what is going on to our brethren. We need to just encourage them and to pray for them, especially in our days today, in our difficult situation. We don't need to bite each other at the back. We just pray and encourage each other for the Lord, because with that we can live victorious. As Paul and Silas, they live victorious because they give thanks, they trust God, they pointed people to the Lord Jesus Christ, and they always think of other people and not for themselves. So I hope this message will remind us that whatever situation we have, I know every one of us have a difficult time, we have a problem with our family, with some other with their marriage, others with friends and in jobs and in your workplace. But let's think that God is always in control. we need to always give thanks whatever situation we have, so we don't need to yung magmukmuk, yung mag ano ba yan, yung mawala ng pag-asa, don't lose hope, because it's, we know if we are in the will of God, we know that God is always in control. That's why they said, in everything, give thanks. Whatever situation we have, ano man yung natatanggap natin, ano man yung kinakain natin, di ba? Well, we praise God because, alam niyo po, yung panahong pandemic na to, kung kailan nagka-pandemic, doon ako nakahawak ng limpak-limpak na salapin. Di ba? Yung sabihin, blessing, sana magka-pandemic ulit, isa pa. Hindi po, but God is in control. Pero at least, parang prepare yun ng Panginoon para magamit, di ba? Nagamit, salamat sa Panginoon. He really planned, He sustained us, and until now, we're still here because God will always provide. But sometimes when we look at our bank, ngayon po, tatlo yung bangko ko eh. Nagbukas ako ng bagong bangko. May tigpa $5 ang laman eh. Kung mawi-withdraw lang yun, withdrawin ko eh. Hindi lang mawi-withdraw eh. $15 din yun, no? If we are just look on our situation, we will just complain. But if we will look to God, we can give thanks and praise God for what's happening in our life. I hope this will encourage us that we need to stay in the will of God and be thankful to Him. Let's all stand up. Let's pray.